Thank you. To the future officers of the court, future justices of the Supreme Court, that's an introduction I cannot say in other law schools, so I'll say it here. To our very youthful dean, my professor, from whom I learned that you can get a grade lower than 5 in recitation. To Secretary Tony Roman of the PLLO, to Attorney Roan Libarios of the IBP Integrated Bar, to Attorney Sal Panelo, to our friends in the media, and to my professors, it's good to be back. But somehow instinctively, I am trembling because I see Dean Magalyona, and I naaalala ko yung pinakamababa kong grado sa law school. Nakikita ko si Professor Ed Labitag, at naaalala ko yung 2-hour oral exam niya sa property. Nakikita ko si Florin Hilbay, bar top notcher, at kasama ko po, and other professors. Good afternoon po sa ating lahat. Sa akin, since this is just an introduction, I'm only here as Miro Kimbo's sidekick. I'm a believer in keeping things basic, no? For this introduction, I like to keep it simple. Ano po yung purpose ng isang impeachment? It is to hold high officials of the country accountable. There are only 31 officials, public officials, who can be held accountable under our constitution. I'm sure you know this all by heart, the 31, the president, vice president, etc., etc., civil service commission, etc., etc. And that is what we seek to do. Always, that is our guiding star, yung purpose po ng impeachment. Yung grounds, those are, we can argue about that, but we'll always go back to the purpose of an impeachment, and that is to hold a high official accountable to the people. We are acting not as representatives of our district, we are acting not just as lawyers, but as those who were made responsible under the Constitution. May responsibilidad po kami. Sabi ng iba, politika to. Sabi ng iba, kinakawawa namin si Chief Justice. Hindi po. Nalulungkot nga kami na umabot sa ganitong hantungan. Ayaw na namin na umabot dito. Pero, nandito na po tayo at kailangan natin panagutin ang mga opisyales sa kanilang ginawa habang sila ay nakupo sa kanilang tungkulin para hindi nila makalimutan na ang sinisilbihan po nila ay ang taong bayan. Yan po ang unang kong ipapaabot sa inyo. At pangalawa po, sana po huwag nating kalimutan na napakamakasaysayan itong ginagawa po natin. Huwag nating isipin na ito ay isang isolated episode na nagbabangayan yung Supreme Court at yung Kongreso o kaya ang Executive Branch at ang Supreme Court. We must look back over our history. We had our first impeachment case, I think, during the time of President Quirino. Sinunod nun, nung time ni President Marcos, there was an attempt in the Batasan Pambansa to impeach him by the opposition. At dumating po tayo, fast forward po tayo, sa panahon ni Erap Estrada. It was the first time a president was impeached in the House of Representatives. Sumunod po yung impeachment ni Chief Justice Davide, ngunit hindi natuloy po. Andun rin po yung impeachment ni COMELEC Commissioner Tangkangko, ni Ombudsman Aniano Desierto, ni GMA, ni Ombudsman Merceditas Gutierrez. Now, it is the first time we are going to try a Chief Justice of the Supreme Court because hindi natuloy yung kay Chief Justice Davide. So wag po nating kalilimutan yung history. Ano po ang common thread niyan? It is to hold people accountable. It is part of strengthening our democracy. At ang pinag-aawayan po namin ni Congressman Kimbo dito is yung prinsipyong yon. At hopefully, we will emerge from it a stronger body politic. Mas malakas po ang ating demokrasya. Mas malakas tayo bilang isang lipunan. Mas malakas po tayo bilang individual at bilang bansa. Maraming salamat po.
Our next guest who will give us a message is the present IBP president. He finished his political science degree from the University of the Philippines, of course, and the College of Law with me in the year 1984. He was elected vice governor of Agusan del Norte and became its representative from 1998 to 2001. He was also among the youngest members of the House who composed the prosecution panel in the impeachment case against President Joseph Estrada. He founded his liberal law office, which is active in litigation and appellate practice. And his membership in the IBP, his leadership in the IBP is bearing fruit through other advocacies. And among these is their participation in Lente, the convener of the Legal Network for Truthful Elections. And recently, he called me to a meeting with the IBP chair for the Women's Committee, because during his term, he is committed to strengthen the IBP Women's Human Rights Committee. And so, my friends, please welcome my classmate, I think I told him, very courageous to be in the minority. And he said that we in UP are quite used to it. So please welcome Roan Libarios.
Thank you, classmate. That's correct. I feel that in this forum today, I am in the minority. Much of that may be due to the fact that the potential successors, of course, will be coming from UP. And despite the fact that the person being impeached happens to come from the other law school, I still believe that the best school is the University of the Philippines College of Law. I hope my position this afternoon will not be a basis for charging me of treason here in the College of Law. Anyway, my respects to our youthful-looking Dean, Dean Danny Concepcion. My another favorite Dean, Dean Magaliona, who is our editor-in-chief of the IBP Law Journal. Professor Labitag, who is also with the IBP Law Journal, and Professor Hilbay, also of the IBP Law Journal. And other members of media, Secretary Roman, Attorney Sal Panelo, our future senators, Senator Kimbo and Senator Angara. But they are deserving senators of the land, huh? Coming from the top law school of the country. Okay, I hope I have not missed other important personalities, but siguro na-recognize naman kanina. Let me just start with our agreements here. Sabi ni Bing, 5 minutes lang yung aming opening statements. So I think everybody of us here, lahat naman tayo nagkakasundo, na yung impeachment process is a constitutional process. It is a constitutional mechanism to enforce public accountability. And the Chief Justice, just like other, like the Ombudsman, the Sandigan Bayan Justices, and the other members of the Constitutional Commissions, all of them can be removed by the process of impeachment. And we also agree that the process of impeachment is the sole prerogative of the House of Representatives, which include our two future senators here. So, but all of us are agreed on these basic principles. Eh, bakit nagkakaiba ang posisyon ng IBP personally at saka yung grupo namin sa incumbent board in this case of the impeachment? Number one, kami po naniniwala sa rule of law. And when we reviewed the process in the impeachment, napakalaki po ang problema sa naging proseso. Alam naman ng lahat na even in the Constitution, it is clearly provided that an impeachment may only be initiated by a verified complaint. Yung kanilang final na complaint, with all due respect to the members of the House, nakalagay verified complaint. It was signed by 188 congressmen and congresswomen. And alam naman natin lahat ang naging proseso dito na it was signed without reading kasi isang kopya lang ang binigay doon sa caucus. It was treated as a done deal. Isang kopya lang at pumila lahat ng mga kongresista dito, parang pumirma lang ng isang attendance sheet. There was no discussion at all. There was no deliberation at all. There was even no actual reading of the allegations in the complaint. Kinumpute namin kung magbabasa bawat congressman dito sa isang kopya lang nasa loob ng caucus room, it will take them 4 days bago matapos. Kung pagtaga 5 minutes lang bawat kongresista ang magbabasa ng complaint na yon. So, ang requirement ng Constitution, verified complaint. May underlying processes ho, ang verified complaint. Kailangan meron kang belief, you form the belief based on actual reading of the allegations in the complaint and the supporting documents nakalagay doon. And there is proper evaluation of the documents and the allegations in the complaint. In this particular case, alam naman ng lahat na nakalagay lang doon sa isang PowerPoint presentation. It was a summary presentation of the PowerPoint. And there is a public admission widespread na yung mga kongresista natin na pumirma, hindi naman talaga binasa yung complaint. Secondly, hindi rin dumaan sa proper swearing-in process na kailangan bawat isang kongresista itumayo, humarap sa isang sa Secretary General, babasahin yung mga allegations ng sa verification at sumunod sila doon. And it will take another several hours to complete the entire process kasi 188 ang pumirma. And thirdly, the more important thing, tama yung sinasabi nila, more than one-third ang pumirma doon sa complaint. And so there must be, so the entire process of referring it to the Committee on Justice is dispensed with. That is correct. But what is dispensed with is only the referral to the Committee on Justice but not the obligation on the part of the complainants to determine the existence, the sufficiency in form and substance, and the existence of probable cause. That is part of due process, an essential component of due process. But in this case, how can they proceed with their own determination on the existence of probable cause and the sufficiency in form and substance given the fact na halos hindi na binasa yung complaint at walang diskusyon, walang deliberation, walang minutes, nothing at all. Even in the plenary, wala rin nangyaring deliberation. Now, unlike in the case of Mercy Gutierrez, we supported the process because it adhered to the processes in the impeachment. And even in the case of former President Erap Estrada, there was a proper referral of the complaint doon sa Committee on Justice. Dumaan din sa ilang buwan ang deliberation sa Committee on Justice. In this particular case, umabot lang sa 2 oras. Nagpirmahan, parang sabi nga namin, parang attendance sheet lang pinirmahan ng ating mga kagalang-galang na kongresista. So I think there was improper observance. And we in the IBP, considering yung core values namin is rule of law, we cannot accept and we cannot support and we have to disagree with the process that failed to comply with the constitutional requirements and the guarantee of due process of law. Eh, sana maintindihanin natin, medyo malungkot kami kasi nga tinatanggal natin dito ay hindi isang ordinaryong opisyal. He is the Chief Justice of the Supreme Court. Sana binigyan ng ating mga kasamahan sa Kongreso ng konting decency, konting respeto. Hindi yung parang 2 oras lang, andun ka na kaagad sa Senado, transmitted na kaagad without any deliberation. That is where we have to disagree. And we beg to disagree with all due respect, no, to the members of the House. Na nahihirapan kaming tanggapin yan. Because if that can be done to a Chief Justice of the land, what will prevent a majority bloc in Congress from using the same blitzkrieg process in gross disregard of the rules and in a display of the tyranny of the majority, from cherry-picking on other constitutional officers if the constitutional officer would disagree with the respective positions in Congress. Yun yung nakikita naming potential threat dito that will set a bad precedent. Kasi alam naman natin yung politika sa Pilipinas. A coalition in the House, a majority coalition in the House, may resort to the same mode of impeachment in gross disregard of the procedure, with blitzkrieg, in blitzkrieg fashion, could initiate a removal process. So dito kami nagkakaroon ng basic disagreement on matters of procedure. Now, on second aspect, dun sa matters of substance naman, nung binasa namin yung complaint, nakita rin namin, we conducted a thorough deliberation. We had, I think, 3 days of deliberation with the board. We invited some load-ins. And it was a product of our own appreciation of the core values of the IBP, yung rule of law, judicial independence, and separation of powers. And using our core values, we arrived at that position. Ang sinasabi namin dito, kung titignan natin yung complaint, basically they involve collegial decisions of the Supreme Court. And for example, yung sinasabi about the TRO, about the Truth Commission, Executive Order Number 2, Dinagat Islands decision, the decision in the decisions in the redistricting, and the status quo ante order. So these are decisions of the Supreme Court. Many of them, or some of them, are still pending consideration before the Supreme Court now. At walang allegation dito na sinasabi na nagkabayaran dito. Walang allegation dito na sinasabi merong irregularities o may anomalya sa naging decision dito. At kung titignan din natin, si Chief Justice, yung hinahabla natin dito, hindi siya naging ponente ni minsan sa mga decisions na nakasite dito sa complaint. Hindi rin siya nag-flip-flop. Kung anong stand niya sa start ng kaso, sa merits, tuloy-tuloy. May mga nag-flip-flop other justices, but not him, based on sa records. So nagka-problema naman kami dito. There is no allegation of any financial consideration or illegal consideration. And there is an admission that these decisions are collegial in nature, made by the entire Supreme Court. And yet we are singling out somebody who is a member of the court who was not even the ponente of any of the decisions and who did not commit any flip-flopping of the decisions. Doon kami nagkakaproblema because okay sana kung sinabi natin doon sa allegations ng complaint, si Chief Justice ay tumanggap ito. And sa kaso na ito, sa decision na ito, meron siyang problema kasi naglakad ito sa mga justices. O binraso niya yung mga decision dito. O nagkaroon ng mga anomalya sa mga decision. And yet, the complaint does not allege those anomalies. So parang tinitignan namin yung implication nito. Parang Congress is now acting as the final interpreter, a super Supreme Court. Sinasabi ng Congress, yung decision ng Korte Suprema sa Truth Commission is unconstitutional. Therefore, they should be removed. Ang tingin namin naman dito, pwede nagkamali ang Korte Suprema, even among ourselves. We are divided on the issue. Even the board. Eh, kahit nga kami divided on issue, pwede, we can criticize the Supreme Court, but not ask for the removal without any other allegations. Pwede kami nagkamali ang Supreme Court sa TRO. Ang sabi ng iba, valid ang TRO issuance kasi wala pang pending case in court. And we all know, pag lawyers, you cannot deny a constitutional right kung wala pang pending case in court. That was a legitimate dispute. Even the board would be divided on that. Maraming kaso dito, the board may be divided on the issue out of their reasonable appreciation based on logic and based on the evidence and based on political philosophy. Now, just because it so happened that the decision of the Supreme Court does not sit well with the leadership in the House or in the office of the President, there is already a valid basis to seek for the impeachment or removal. That is the bigger question here, because that will send a chilling effect on judicial independence. At alam naman natin, ang Korte Suprema is the least dangerous of all branches of government. Wala siyang sword, wala siyang power of the purse, sa kanya lang passive power of judicial review. And that power can only be exercised if there's a case filed before the Supreme Court. Kung walang kaso, it cannot intervene. Unlike Congress, unlike Senate, it can directly intervene, initiate its own investigation. Yung Supreme Court natin, walang power. It's only passive judicial review. Now, if that passive judicial review is now being under threat because they can be subjected to impeachment based on the same decisions, some of them still pending before the Supreme Court now. Yung TRO, yung Dinagat Islands, some are still pending in the Supreme Court. Hindi ho ba parang meron tayong interference na dito sa proseso ng Korte Suprema? Yun ang nagiging problema natin dito, yung potential implications that the impeachment may be used no longer as a tool to enforce public accountability, but as a tool for political partisanship and to secure political ends. Yun yung question namin dito sa IBP. I think I have already taken my time. So I will end with that. Nang sinasabi natin, on trial here is not only the Chief Justice. Sabi nga namin, kahit sinong justice yan. Si Corona, si Carpio, si Peralta o sino. Pag kinasuhan ng ganitong klaseng kaso na walang proseso at yung grounds hindi maliwanag, magsasalita pa rin yung IBP. Incidental si Chief Justice Corona dito. Ang tinitingnan namin, yung manner by which the impeachment process is being used. Thank you and good afternoon.